play, record, stop, and loop inside of Logic Pro 10, all with the Maschine MK3. Hey guys, Stefan here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to configure your Maschine MK3 inside of the controller editor to control Logic's transport, almost to the same degree as the Complete Control keyboard, allowing you to play, record, stop, and loop. At this point of recording, this is not yet achievable with the MK3 right out of the box. So this is a useful workflow if you want to use the Maschine as your main production hub within the Maschine software, but also, and the reason for this video, within Logic Pro 10. With the added bonus of being able to record MIDI information straight into Logic with the pads. This was lacking from all of the workflows I have previously seen, so I came up with this one. Please check the description for software versions, as these may play effect on this workflow actually working for you. With that being said, let's jump right in. Please listen carefully and watch the full video, as the setup is quite delicate with many variables and places to make mistakes. I'm going to go as slow as possible, and I've also included some subtitles to help you follow along. First, we must open up the controller editor. Once opened, we need to create a new template. Under Templates, click Edit and New. We could actually use the Mackie control settings here and call it a day, which some of you may be thinking. However, with the Mackie control settings, we won't be able to use the pads as drum pads. So although it will get us part way there, it won't get us the full way. So I think it's better that we just start from scratch and just take what we need from the Mackie control settings and set up our pads to work within Logic so we can record straight onto Logic's arrange window. So with our new template created, we can go ahead and rename it whatever we like just to keep us focused. And from here, we want to click on Host Transport Control to set ourselves up for controlling Logic Pro 10's transport. Like I said, this will be a simple Logic Pro 10 setup, but once you learn the main processes and principles, you can go ahead and go all out with your own custom configurations. Okay, so let's begin assigning each button. Click on the button you would like to assign. Let's start with play. You can click on this on the actual hardware itself or on the screen. It doesn't matter. It will do the same thing. Then go to assign. And we want to change the button type to an MCU button. And then change the parameter ID to 94. How do I know it's 94? Well, by clicking and slowly dragging on the box here, we can actually see what each parameter will do. Not all of them work perfectly inside of Logic and do exactly what they say here, so I'm just sticking with the ones that I know will. Feel free to experiment. Next, record, which is parameter ID 95. Next, we have stop, parameter ID 93. And finally, loop, which is parameter ID 86. This information is also included in the description below and also in the full blog post. Now, if we want to move our playhead with the four-way encoder, we need to change its type to MCU will under turn. And then off under push and off under touch. So as you can see there, we can actually turn buttons off too. And that's very useful if you want to keep your Maschine focused, as turned off buttons will not be lit on the actual hardware itself. Just to show you how to do this with a different button type, click on the button. Now whilst under assign once again, click on the type drop down menu and select off right at the bottom. Now to save some time here, this is what my configuration looks like with all of the unused buttons turned off. So in summary, all I have on and lit is play, record, stop, loop, the wheel, and CC34, which allows us whilst holding the shift button to come out of MIDI mode. I've also left the encoders and buttons above and below the screens on, just in case we want to assign them to anything inside of Logic. Now the next step is vital. We want to move all of our pads from MIDI channel 1 to MIDI channel 2. And I'll explain why later, but missing this step will lead to undesired results. This is actually really quick to do. Simply click on the first pad, and whilst holding shift on your keyboard, click on the last pad. This will select all of the pads. Now under assignments and hit, change the channel from 1 to 2. Move over to press and change it again from 1 to 2. Now all of the pads on this page transmit on MIDI channel 2 when you hit them and also when you press them. Now leave them selected and move on to the next page, pad page B, and do the same thing. Under hit, change the channel from 1 to 2, then under press, change the channel from 1 to 2. Pad page C, and so on and so forth, all the way to pad page H. This will take about 2 minutes. The final step in this part is not necessary, but adds a nice touch. Go to pages, and change the pad page D to Maschine. Then go to assign, and change the pad page color to whatever color you like. I'm selecting green. This will make sense later on. Okay, so take a breather, we're almost there. Make sure all of your settings are correct, and then we'll move on to the next part. The next step is to open Logic and head to Logic Pro 10, Control Surfaces, and Setup. From here, we need to create a new control surface. But before we do, a quick disclaimer. When working with multiple control surfaces inside of Logic, there is a possibility of conflict. As you can see, I already have the Complete Kontrol control surface set up. Having it already set up, I haven't found there to be any conflict, fortunately, but please be aware of this. If in fact you find that there is conflict causing one or more of your control surfaces to not function properly, you can simply right-click on the control surface and delete it. And then set that control surface back up again. With some control surfaces like the Akai MPK Mini and the Complete Kontrol, you'll get a prompt when you plug in your device for Logic to set up that control surface for you automatically. Others may take a bit more work. However, the issue might be elsewhere. To verify this setup, I also tried it on my laptop, and it didn't work. It turns out that the settings from my Akai MPK Mini found in Control Surfaces, Controller Assignments, was causing the conflict. Deleting everything corresponding to the Akai MPK Mini fixed the issue. Obviously, if it's a control surface that's important to you, you need to be a bit more careful about what you are deleting. Please remember, when it comes to MIDI controllers, you don't necessarily have to have it set up as a control surface. Although I deleted the control surface settings, it does not mean that I cannot use the Akai MPK Mini with Logic Pro 10 anymore. It simply means that the predefined controller assignments have now been deleted, but I'm still able to program MIDI via the notes on the keyboard. So that's something to bear in mind if you feel afraid to delete any keyboard control surfaces that have been set up inside of your Logic. With that out of the way, let's add our new control surface. Head to New, Install, and we want to select Mackie Designs, Mackie Kontrol, Logic Kontrol. We want to make sure that Transport Button Click is checked. It should be automatically, but just verify that it is. And select Maschine MK3 Virtual Input for the Input Port, and Maschine MK3 Virtual Output for the Output Port. We're pretty much good to go. We're able to play notes and record them. Just as a side note, the Mackie Kontrol functions on MIDI channel 1. So to avoid any conflict, I've moved all of the pads to MIDI channel 2. So please be aware of this. By default, Logic runs all of its sounds on all of the MIDI channels, which is why I was able to do this. However, if you're using some sort of multi-timbral setup where it utilizes different MIDI channels for different sounds, then you may run into some problems here. To take it one step further, as you can see, I've colored the pad D green and labeled it Maschine. If you want to record sounds from the Maschine plugin straight into Logic, then you're going to need to be on this pad page. but there is at minimum one more step required in order to use the Maschine plugin in this way. Open the Maschine plugin, selecting the 16x stereo option. Add your group. Be sure to have the plus pattern deselected. And then with group selected over here, click on this icon here. Select input and then change key mode to drum kit. Now we can hit record on our Maschine hardware and record sounds from the Maschine plugin straight into Logic Pro 10. The final step in this setup would be to create a separate output for each sound within the Maschine plugin. As we've already selected the 16x stereo option, this will be a breeze to set up. This time, select sound and then output. Then give each sound its own external output channel from 1 to 16. Now inside of Logic, open the mixer. Then head to the channel hosting the plugin and click the small plus sign to create as many channels as you require, up to 16. Maschine's outputs will now feed into Logic's inputs. Each external output is stereo, hence why it takes up two channels inside of Logic. But most of you would already know that. The controller surface setup inside of Logic and the controller editor configuration inside of the controller editor will both be permanently saved. You can toggle between templates whilst in MIDI mode by simply holding shift and using the arrows here. However, the Maschine plugin settings will not be saved, and that's where you might find it useful to save it as a template or a patch. So that, my friends, is it. That's my full setup. I'm currently working on an even more advanced setup which will give you even more control, but until then, I hope you find this one extremely useful. Please leave feedback and any questions you may have in the comment section below, and subscribe for more advanced setups to help you with your production workflow. I've been Stefan, and as always, happy beat making.